throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and the servants shall worship him. They shall see his face, and his name shall be on their foreheads. Revelation chapter 22, verses 3 and 4. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And one was a doctor, and one was a queen, and one was a shepherdess on the green. One was a soldier, and one was a priest, and one was slain by a fierce wild beast. So goes the great children's hymn for this feast of All Saints that we are celebrating today. The wonderful message of the hymn is that the saints are not all the same, that God calls people to different kinds of holiness, to different ways of manifesting the love, joy, and peace that are his gifts through the redeeming work of Jesus and the creative power of the Holy Spirit. St. Paul, in his brilliant boldness, is different from the Virgin Mary in her gentle and patient faithfulness. St. Francis of Assisi couldn't be more different from St. Leo of Rome, or John Wesley from Lancelot Andrews, or Mother Teresa from Dietrich Bonhoeffer. And yet this day is a day for them all, a day for celebrating God's grace that was present in the great cloud of faithful witnesses that he has raised up in generation after generation. The image that is before you is an All Saints painting, one panel of the great altarpiece at the Cathedral of St Bavo in Ghent, Belgium, painted by the brothers Hubert and Jan van Eyck in 1432. I love this painting so much because I can remember the first time I saw it, a rainy November day in that busy city of Ghent. Unlike so many other of the masterpieces of art, it's not been hauled away to a museum, but still sits in the great cathedral church. And for a few beautiful and quiet moments, I had the great painting to myself. The panel before you stands just above the altar in the center, and it depicts the adoration of the Lamb, that great vision of Christ's triumph in heaven, from St. John's Revelation. Cindy read us part of the story a minute ago. The Van Eyck brothers have painted a whole host of saints coming from the four corners of the earth into that great paradise to worship the Lamb. And they're all different. Their faces have different expressions and features. They are dressed in different ways, reflecting the different things they did on earth. They have grown in different kinds of holiness, serve the people with different gifts, come to heaven by different means. Here on the left are the great heroes of the Old Covenant. You can see kings with their crowns and long bearded prophets. Isaiah is here with a budding branch, a symbol of his great prophecy of the root of Jesse that will spring to life. The coming Messiah. And here are the four evangelists holding up the books that they wrote to proclaim the Lamb who is on the throne. Over on this side in these brown robes, there are the apostles. And behind them are those who have led the church that they have passed on. The popes and their triple crowns, bishops, priests, and deacons, who have served faithfully throughout the generations. Coming in from the back, you can see a company of holy women, some of them bearing the palm branches that mark them out as martyrs. And here, on the other side, are a company of holy men, who bear the men of prayer and teachers, kings and commoners, old and young, all rushing together to adore the Lamb. They're all different, and yet they all push toward the same goal. It is the Lamb, the one whose blood is poured out upon the altar, the one surrounded by the cross and the pillar and the cruel instruments of his death. Of course, he is Christ, the Lamb of God who was slain once for all. And over above them hovers the dove of the Holy Spirit, who sends down his streams of grace, striking them all in different ways, shedding abroad the different gifts and abilities that enable them each to serve God in their own particular manner. Of course, it's fitting to reflect on a painting in this service that introduces our parish art exhibition. We have entitled the exhibition, A Cloud of Witnesses, a phrase from the letter to the Hebrews, describes the heroes of the faith that God has raised up generation after generation, and who still surround us now and support us with their prayers. The saints each witness to a different part of God's purpose. They manifest a different side of holiness. And in the same way, artists see the beauty of the world in different ways. I noticed this afternoon as we were setting up that there are quite a few seascapes among the paintings up above. And yet they are nothing alike. Susan and Lee and Anne have all viewed the ocean, but each has captured a different part of the beauty that God has placed in it. We hope that you will all join us in the parish hall to view the art after the service, and that you'll talk with the artists about these amazing works that they have created and what they are trying to show in paint and pen and wax. The image before us is special to me for another reason, because I see a print of it almost every day. A copy of this painting hangs over the altar at St. James School Chapel. And as we celebrate the Eucharist in our chapel, as in the great cathedral of Ghent, we become aware that these great saints are not just in heaven above, but that they surround us as we worship the same Lamb on the throne. When I consecrated the host in the Holy Eucharist and hold it up to the, for the people to see, it rests just here, right in front of the Lamb seated upon the throne, just as the Van Eycks designed it in Ghent. In every celebration of the Eucharist, we step into that great reality that the painting depicts. We join with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven. And by feeding on that same Lamb of God, and by being filled by that same Holy Spirit, we grow in the holiness that is God's gift to all his saints, the glorious ones in heaven, and we struggling ones below. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.